Welcome to Printful's design series. Today, we're going to go through how to create grids, gutters, and guides in Adobe Illustrator. These will help you make sure that your design is balanced and hierarchical. First, we're going to create a new file. So we'll go to File, New, Print, and select A3. I'm just going to make sure all of my settings are right. For printing, it's best for me to design on a 12 by 16 inch artboard, so I'm gonna make sure my width is set to 12 inches, the height is set to 16 inches, and that I'm in portrait mode. I also need to be in RGB color profile, and my raster effects should be on high. Now that we have our workspace open, I'm gonna create a rectangle by pressing M or using the rectangle tool located here. This rectangle is gonna go all around the artboard. When I release my selection, Illustrator will show me the width and height of my rectangle. If you need to adjust any of your dimensions, like margins, you can do so here. To create our grid, I'm going to go to Object, Path, and select Split into Grid. Then select how many rows and columns you want. For this example, I'm going to use 3 columns and 2 rows, then click on Preview to see how it looks. I also want a bit of space in between the grids so that they're not touching. To do this, I'm gonna have to create a gutter. So I'm gonna add a 15-point gutter just by going to Gutter and writing in 15 for both rows and columns. And now we have our grids. The next step is to turn these grids into guidelines. So I'm gonna head up to View, Guides, and Make Guides. This will create a nice grid of blue lines that you can use to guide your design. Just to help with organization, I'm going to click on my new layer and label it Grid or Guide. Now I can lock my grids and guides so I can turn them on and off while designing. Now I want to make sure that when I move objects, they snap to where they need to be. So I'm going to go to View, Snap to Point, and check the Smart Guides option. At this point, I can add an image and make sure that my image is contained to whatever quadrant it needs to be in for visual balance and hierarchy. Grids and guidelines also come in handy for text and shapes as well. And that's it for today. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon to turn on all the notifications. This way, you'll never miss new videos on our channel.